Kingdom Talk, let's talk about it. It's Thursday. That's right, it's Thursday, and we are back inside the studio of WCC 99.9 FM, and you're in the live broadcast of Kingdom Talk. I am your host, Augustus Washington Jr., and I have a special guest in the studio with us on tonight, and we're going to give him a proper introduction. Really, he needs no introduction. He's been on the broadcast before, and we're grateful to the Lord for him. Amen. Pastor Reginald Grimes, blessing to you, sir. How are you?
Doing good. Great to be with you and with the listening audience.
Amen. Good to have you. And again, we'll get into some things momentarily. But listen, you already know what I need you to do. I need you to get on the phone, call a neighbor, and tell a friend. Kingdom Talk is on the air. And it's November already. It's November the 5th, 2015. So if you're listening to this and it's November the 5th, 2015, at a little bit, about 2 minutes past the hour, 7 p.m., you're listening to the live broadcast. Now, if it's Friday and it's November the 6th, at about 2 minutes past the hour of 2 p.m., you're listening to the rebroadcast, okay? So, again, want to make sure that you know 30 minutes past the hour, you'll be able to call in and chime in with your question or comment. So this is why I want you to know that if it's Thursday, you are definitely listening to the live broadcast and you can call in. But if it's Friday, again, a little after 2, you're listening to the rebroadcast and you won't be able to call in 30 minutes past the hour. But I need all of my Facebookers to get on Facebook. Let me know that you are listening. We're monitoring that page right now. Also, for those of you that like a visual with your commentary, by all means, go to WCC.com, I believe it is, and you'll be able to stroll to the center of the page. You'll see the stream that's coming out of the studio here in New Wellington, South Carolina, and you'll be able to look into the studio and see what's going on and see our guests and all of that wonderful things that go along with that, the visual there. And so we welcome you to do that if you so desire. But also on the same homepage, you'll stroll to the right of that homepage. To the top, you'll see a red tab that says Listen Live. You'll be able to listen live anywhere in the world, actually, on your smartphone, your iPhone, your tablet, your laptop, desktop, internet connection. You have us, okay, anywhere around the world. And again, this is the live broadcast of Kingdom Talk. And so we're grateful to be here. Blessed of the Lord and highly favored. Just thanking God for another chance and opportunity to come to you here with the broadcast. The Lord has blessed us and afforded us an opportunity to do so. And we're grateful to the Lord. Thank God for even this station, WCC 99.9 FM. We give God praise for that and him allowing us to be here. So we're going to pray and we're going to believe God. Also, if you have any prayer requests, if you're on Facebook, you can send it through the inbox, or you can call in at 30 minutes past and get on the prayer list for tonight as well. You have a birthday anniversary, you can send us that through Facebook as well, and we'll give you a great big God bless you on your anniversary or your birthday here on Kingdom Talk. We'll welcome that here tonight. Okay. If you have a question or comment and you want to remain anonymous, you don't want your identity revealed, by all means, hit us up in the inbox on Kingdom Talk. We will entertain the question or the comment without revealing your identity. OK, so that's what we want you to do. And prayerfully, you'll be able to do that at any time throughout the broadcast. OK. All right. So what we're going to do now, we're going to pray and we're going to believe God for a blessed broadcast on tonight, and then we'll get into some particulars. Father, in Jesus' name, we give you praise and we thank you now for this time and for this opportunity to be able to come before you with this Kingdom Talk broadcast. We ask that you would bless the listeners and those that will listen later on. We pray, oh God, and even now, apply the blood of Jesus over the broadcast in the name of Jesus. We speak life over the those that are listening right now. We speak life over the broadcast in Jesus' name. We thank you for this opportunity and we give you praise for it right now. And we say thank you and we believe in you for it. A blessing, and those that will listen will be edified by the broadcast. In Jesus' precious name we do pray, amen. All right. Well, listen, we are live in the studio tonight. It's again November the 5th, I'm almost about to say the 11th. It's November the 5th, 2015, live inside the studios tonight. Going to be dealing with a few things tonight as it relates to mind, body, and soul. But we're going to deal with it from the perspective of some things as it relates to our social order where we are prophetically, as well as in general of what that means is how we should function in the kingdom of God. Our special guest tonight is Pastor Reginald Grimes. I always say pastor, you're not pastoring at this moment, but you've been pastoring for years, so we'll just keep it right there.
It's the call on my life.
Yes, amen. You're a pastor at heart. And so we'll stay with that. We'll go with that. But just before we get into the particulars of what we want to deal with tonight, I want to ask you, what is God saying to you as just a ministry gift to the body? Is it anything particular that he's speaking to you, or is it anything particular that you sense that you need to deal with as it relates to the body of Messiah Jesus?
I guess the one thing that continuously keeps coming back, and it keeps bringing me back to it, is for the body of Christ to really understand the nature of who they are,
mm-hmm.
that they are a spirit being created in the image and likeness of God. But because of sin, we lost that likeness.
Yes.
Until such time we were born again. But in the meantime, we was actually operating out of basically just our soulish realm, our soul and our body.
Yes.
My mind, will, emotions, and intellect. And that is the area that the enemy has wreaked havoc in, because that's his playground.
Mm-hmm.
And as a result of that, many believers, though wondrously, gloriously saved,
mm-hmm.
still are dealing with issues internally,
yes.
in their soulish realm. In many cases, we're not able, or we're not walking in the victory that we're supposed to have,
yes.
because of a lot of these entrapments. Hmm. So it's having to understand what's going on in those areas, and then recognize that God has already provided or made provision for us to walk victoriously in them. But you can't walk victoriously in them until you at least identify and know that they're there.
Amen.
Yeah.
Absolutely. So the Lord is dealing with you more to deal with that. And I guess so that the believer can walk in victory rather than so much defeat.
Exactly. Because I use this analogy, well, it's not really an analogy, but it's saying every thought that comes to you is not your thought.
Absolutely.
And since it's not your thought, that means you do not have to own it just because it came in your mind.
Exactly.
So that's where the enemy's playground is. So he sows thoughts, and these seeds, the thoughts are seeds, and as a result of them, how we respond to them makes the difference as to things that transpire in our life.
Hmm.
Because thoughts become our words, and our words become our actions. The actions become our habits, and those habits become our destiny.
Absolutely.
So as a result of that, we can speak a lot of things negatively concerning ourselves, and it's not in line with what God is saying about us in his word. So therefore, we can't walk in the victory because we have been negatively conditioned in this world system. So we have to recognize that. And in order to flip the script, so to speak,
mm-hmm.
we have to speak and say what God is saying.
Yes.
Even though the thought may come to me, but that doesn't mean that I have to receive it, accept it, or act on it.
Absolutely.
So there is power available. But we have to at least identify those things, those areas, and recognize that this is what the enemy is seeking to do,
mm-hmm.
in order to keep us from actually being victorious.
So what would you say to the quote-unquote believer that's being drawn into the narrative, the narrative that the media is putting out now? Of course, you see where the devil is really wreaking havoc on the racial divide,
mm-hmm.
and so many of these things. And many times I even see on Facebook where there's a constant thing with they're showing where cops are doing unjust things, should I say. And we do know that these things are happening. However, the media's narrative of it all is that it's majority that's happening, you know. And we know that all cops are not bad, but we do know that there is some corruption.
Right.
I guess my question is this. As believers, we shouldn't fall in the trap, number one, that the narrative that he's putting out. And then what should that believer do to combat these things? Because there's definitely an attack that the enemy is putting forth with this particular narrative. That's just one.
Mm-hmm.
So how do we deal with that, with this concept or this conversational piece of mind, soul, and body?
Well, first of all, when we start looking...
Or should we say spirit, soul, and body? Yeah. That's what we're really saying.
When we see these things that are happening in our society, in and around us, we got to recognize where the source of that is coming from.
Mm-hmm.
The media amplifies it because the enemy wants it amplified,
mm-hmm.
because the idea is to create fear and terror on the inside of us.
Yes.
To make us believe that there is no hope.
Mm-hmm.
And as a result of those things, when that begins to start taking place, then it moves us from the love walk that we're supposed to walk in as the body of Christ.
Absolutely.
And as a result of that, we can very easily get caught up with the anger. We can easily get caught up where these things begin to move us and move our emotions.
Yes.
And now we'll begin speaking the same vein that the rest of society is speaking.
Yes.
Not trying to ignore what's happening, but we have to recognize as the body of Christ that according to the word, our enemy is not flesh and blood.
Yes. Yes. And that is so true, Pastor Grimes, because what I'm seeing is that many are really falling into the trap that the devil is putting out.
Mm-hmm.
And if we actually research history, we'll find that God's intention throughout the eons of time is for us to work together.
Exactly.
And it has been that even in back in the 1700s and 1800s, people don't realize that black and white were together in many cases,
mm-hmm.
but the only narrative you hear is the separation or the slavery. And so we fall into that trap, and we fall into the unforgiveness and the anger, as you said, and the hate. But the scripture tells us again that we're not wrestling against flesh and blood, what you just quoted, but against principalities, against mm-hmm. powers. So I want to get into some of this as to how the believer should function in the earth in a different system, but yet deal with the issues of today without becoming the problem, but being agents of change as it relates to this dynamic of spirit, soul, and body. Because we're first spirit.
Mm-hmm.
We live in a body.
That's right.
But we have a soul.
Right.
So let's go with that. Let's speak to that for me.
As a believer, when we look around, we know that we have saved brothers and sisters in Christ.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have the unsaved.
Yes.
But if I start from the premise, that's probably the most important verse mm-hmm. that we learned growing up, first coming into church or the Bible, John 3:16.
Absolutely.
For God so loved the world.
Mm-hmm.
And that word world is in reference to everybody that was not in relationship with him.
Mm-hmm.
But he loves them.
Yes.
And that's the reason why Christ came to die. So therefore, every person that we run across white, black, green, blue, Asian, doesn't matter. Mm-hmm. God says, I love them.
Yes.
And my love for them is unconditional. But even though I love them, they may not be in relationship with me.
Yes.
But you are.
Yes.
So you are my agent of change.
Ah.
You are the representation of my love walking in the earth.
Hmm.
So as a result of that, when I have to see that, there's brothers and sisters in Christ that I may not be able, first of all, I can't even communicate with because our natural language is not the same.
Yes.
But yet, that's still my brother or sister in Christ.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's brothers and sisters in Christ, and because we all deal with stuff, and we may be at different levels, we may not necessarily communicate that well together.
Yes.
So I got to recognize that, one, if you've been born again, then I have to receive you as my brother or sister in Christ.
Mm.
If you're not born again, it's God's desire that you would come into a relationship with him.
Right.
So then everything should be geared toward how is it that I might be able to influence or impact your life in a way that will direct your attention to the God that made you, the God that died for you, the God that loves you.
Which is what Jesus came to do. We know ultimately reconciliation back to the Father,
mm-hmm.
to give us and show us the ability as to what we should have been from the beginning, how to function in the kingdom, etc. But when he comes into the earth, he shows us the heart of the Father. He shows us how we should function. He says, this is what he wants for you, even though they're not saved.
Mm-hmm.
This is what you should have. And he's pretty much, I guess you could say, he gets 12 to teach them the language.
Yes.
If you will, mm-hmm. if we could use that phraseology, to teach them the language as to what they needed to do in order to be able to function like he was functioning. So if we're going to be that example, even as Jesus was, then to be that agent of change, then we are the ones that have to say, okay, we know that these things are happening. However,
yes,
we've got to give you the language as to how to deal with the situation and not cause the situation to grow,
mm-hmm.
or to get worse, if you will.
Exactly.
You see what I mean?
So we have to then demonstrate the kingdom that Jesus brought to the earth.
Mm-hmm.
As he said, the kingdom of heaven has come. He's come to represent it.
Yes.
And now the language. First of all, we got to understand who our source is.
Absolutely.
That in spite of the things that may be going on around us, our source is the Father,
mm-hmm.
is God himself. So even in the midst of times when you may be ill-treated, and those things happen and are going to happen,
mm-hmm.
As long as we're going to be in the earth, but when we recognize our source,
mm-hmm.
he gives us the inner peace and the strength to be able to demonstrate his love, to demonstrate his mercy, to demonstrate his grace, even in the midst of everything else that's going on around us. And as a result, it may not be everybody,
uh-huh.
but it will be somebody.
Yes.
And some bodies that will see us, watch us, recognize it, and be drawn to him. Because there's going to be a difference. There's going to be a difference between what folks hear,
mm-hmm.
and see all day long. And then all of a sudden, there's somebody that is showing me something that doesn't line up with all of the mess that I hear and the stuff that I see most of the time.
I have a question for you, and then I'm going to social media. I'm going to let you answer the question after I come from social media. I have a question for you because someone's listening right now and they say, okay, I hear Brother Grimes, I hear Brother Washington, they talking, you know, real good, but their child didn't get slammed and thrown across the floor. Their son didn't get murdered by a cop for no reason, so they can say these things, etc. I want you to speak to that when I come back from social media, because you were talking about showing that love of God and what have you. How do we show the love of God and express the love of God in adverse situations? How do we nullify? How do we dilute? How do we diffuse a situation like that? And then how do we get over it? Because one of the conversational pieces that came up in Bible study on last night was unforgiveness, which is a very, 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 in my humble opinion, which it's very touchy. Mm-hmm. And it's very, I think, a significant conversational piece because it's so much of it. Mm-hmm. I know I throw it a lot at you, but I want you to meditate and kind of mull on that for a minute. I'm going to go to social media, and I want you to speak to that when I come back to you, okay?
Okay.
All right, you're listening to the live broadcast of Kingdom Talk. It's about 22 minutes now past the hour of 7 p.m. I am your host, Augustus Washington Jr., and my special guest in tonight is Pastor Reginald Grimes, and we're thanking him for being here with us tonight. I want to go to social media right now. I want to say a great big God bless you to Sarah Bennett. She's tuned in and listening. God bless you. Also to Carlina Miles. She's tuned in and listening tonight, as well as Jacqueline Surrey is tuned in, as well as Tequila Surrey is tuned in and listening. Remember now, if you're listening on Facebook, you can send your question or comment in at any moment of the broadcast on tonight, and we'll get that we'll entertain that on tonight. So you can send that in at any moment, we'll entertain it. But remember, 30 minutes now past the hour, 7 p.m I'm gonna open up the phone lines and have some dialogue with you, our listening audience. So thank all of you for tuning in again, and let somebody else know on Facebook that the live broadcast of Kingdom Talk is on right now. And I'm excited about the broadcast tonight because I think it's some interesting dialogue, just for me anyway, if for no one else. So tell a neighbor, tell a friend, Kingdom Talk is on 30 minutes past the hour. We're going to open up the phone lines. But you that are listening on Facebook, you can chime in at any moment now. And also for those that may be watching even by Ustream, I want to say a great big God bless you to you. We're going to wave to the camera. God bless you. Wave to them, Pastor. They listening. They looking. Amen. God bless you. All right. You remember what I asked you. I want you to speak to that right now.
Well, first of all, one, you cannot deny the anger of someone who has had a child or somebody that has broken into a home and you know, somebody has had to suffer as a result of the actions of somebody else.
Yes, sir.
So you don't just displace that automatically. So first of all, we have to be real with where we are.
Okay.
I'm angry. I am hurt. I'm mad. Mm-hmm. In some cases, we'll be mad at God because we say you allowed this to happen.
Okay. Now, if you're listening, if you're taking notes, you need to write that down, what he just said. You got to take ownership and confess that yeah. I'm angry.
This is where I'm at.
Yes.
God's big enough to handle it. Now, doesn't mean that the pain is going to go away because it's not going to happen overnight.
Right.
Should it have happened? No. But it did anyway.
Mm-hmm.
So now how do I respond to it?
Yes.
I got to be honest with where I'm at. I got to be honest with God. I got to be honest with other people.
Yes.
To recognize, okay, I'm not in a position to really deal with this right now.
Okay.
Because right now I really want to hurt this other individual.
That's true.
But this is not what God would have for me.
Absolutely.
So now I got to recognize in my strength, I can't do this.
Mm-hmm.
So I just got to keep bringing it to him. You want me to love, but you got to put it in me.
Yes.
I can say the words that I forgive him, but I'm not feeling that on the inside.
Mm-hmm.
But as long as I'm honest with where I am with him, then that is what opens the door for him to begin to work on the inside of me.
Is there something that the individual has to do to, you know, you made the statement that I want to love them, but Lord, you have to give me basically the ability. I'm probably not quoting you verbatim, mm-hmm. but basically the ability to love. Is there something that the individual have to do in order for when they make that kind of a statement? Well, is there something that individual has to do to help facilitate that happening in their life?
Well, one, I got to recognize that, again, every thought that comes to me is not my thought.
Mm-hmm.
The enemy would desire for me to walk in hatred.
Yes.
But at the same time, once I acknowledge that to the Lord, I have to continue to do so. Now, along with my prayer life, and now we're only dealing with believers here,
mm-hmm.
but there's unbelievers out there that really don't have a relationship with God, that they won't be hearing this because they don't have that relationship with him.
Uh-huh.
But the danger is this thing will eat at you to where it will erode your own life away. That's why it's important that we recognize it and be able to give it back to you. So give it back to the Lord. Mm-hmm. Give us back to the Lord.
Yes.
For the believer, that's the only way that you're going to be able to survive this. Stay in the Word,
mm-hmm.
and allow it to begin, and allow the Spirit of God that's already inside of you to begin speaking to you. So you got to talk to him and say, look, I need to hear from you.
Okay.
So open, you know, show me, help me.
Yes.
Just be blatantly honest. This is where I'm at.
Yeah.
It's not where I want to be. I can't stay here. But at the same time, I gotta be real about where I'm at. So
absolutely.
The more you do so, and just recognize it's not going to happen overnight.
Right.
This is a process. And he will walk us through the process.
Yes.
And many times, you know, even with great intentions, we won't necessarily know what to say to our friends or to our loved ones who are going through this kind of pain.
Mm-hmm.
And I would encourage you, if you have a friend or a loved one that's going through, you need to be praying.
Absolutely.
As to how you respond, because sometimes there's not anything you can say that's going to make anything better.
That's true.
Sometimes all you have to do is just be there.
Yes.
They can just see. You don't have to say anything. You're just there to let them know I'm here. And then there's times you have to be honest. I don't know what to say.
Yes. That's one of the things I think that we mess up a lot of times. Sometimes we think we have to say something.
Yeah.
But sometimes your presence is enough.
Exactly.
You know, and we got to know when that is. It's right at 30 minutes now past the hour, 7 p.m. Let me say this, too, that it is the first Thursday in the month. Normally, this is open forum Thursday. So if you have a question concerning the Word of God that we may not be discussing tonight, and only tonight, we give you an opportunity. We'll give you an opportunity to ask that question. On any particular topic, because every first Thursday in the month is always open forum Thursday. So you can ask any question that's biblically, a biblical question or something that's related to how you should respond biblically. You can ask that question tonight. Your numbers of access are 803-335-3131. Again, your numbers of access are 803-335-3131. The phone lines are open right now. The Kingdom Talk phone lines are open right here at the studio of WCC 99.9 FM. If you have a question for Pastor Grimes or myself, you know, you can call in right now, or you can hit us up on Facebook on Kingdom Talk. We are monitoring that page right now as we speak, and we'll do our very best to answer that question or entertain the comment. So you can do so now. Phone lines are open. Again, your numbers of access are 803-335-3131. We're going to the Kingdom Talk phone lines right now. Caller, you are live on the air. What's your question or comment? And tell me what town you're calling from?
Apostle Washington, this is Pastor Brian Finley, and I'm calling you tonight from Evans, Georgia.
Well, praise God, and, Pastor Finley.
How are you guys doing tonight?
Doing absolutely good. Wonderful.
Listen, just wanted to tell you I've been listening in tonight, and don't normally always get a chance to do so because of the schedule and everything, but
yes, sir.
Just the Lord just ordained for it to happen tonight that I was listening to your show. And just wanted to tell those that are listening tonight that may be out there that are going through things when you're talking about the hurt and the pain of dealing with circumstances in your life.
Yes, sir.
I went through something over 2 years ago that was really personal to me that had happened in my own life. And I found myself covering up the pain, covering up the time that I needed to heal and pushing myself forward in ministry mm-hmm. instead of taking time to step back and really focus on what God was wanted me to do, you know, and taking care of the pain and all that, and I let it build up over time and all that. Well, it just so happened this past 2 weeks now, the Lord has really been dealing with me about going back and really dealing with the fact mm-hmm. of letting go of the things of life that have drawn yeah. me to remember the pain, to remember the hurt, remember those things that have happened, and to truly, I'd already forgiven the person, but to truly move through the what I would say is the reconciliation of knowing that that I never dealt with it emotionally. And I had lunch with Bishop John Aguilar the other day, and he looked at me and said something so profound in my life. He said, I ask you this, you know, how deep are you in the Word? How deep are you in your prayer time? And, you know, a lot of times we get busy as pastors and we have our prayer time, and we have our time of fasting and prayer and reading the Word of God. But to our own selves, how many times do we forget the fact that we are still dealing with things our own selves emotionally that
yes.
we put aside that for our people that we're ministering to and we're loving them, but sometimes God expects us to step back and deal with our own personal life sometimes
right.
and do that. And last night I was able to visit with a dear friend of mine, Pastor Nate Barber, with the Good News Church last night, and was able to visit with them and to sit down and Pastor Susie, Pastor Matt's wife, began to speak on the fact of living by faith. And when she talked about it, she said, there's people that get to some points in life and they keep trying to get over something, and you end up taking steps back instead of taking steps forward. And she said that, you know, you're right now God's telling you by faith that you can conquer this thing, and he's giving you instructions as to how to do it. So one thing I want to add to your comments tonight is this, and I want to close with this, just say this, is that ministers, it don't matter who you are, if you're just a regular churchgoer, when you deal with hurt or if you deal with things in life and you try to just hide it and put it away,
yes.
eventually you're going to deal with it, mm-hmm. and eventually it's going to come to a head.
Right.
And when it does, you need to understand that you're dealing with it from the perspective of this. I always told people before I went through the thing I went through 2 years ago, that if I went through it, I would take somebody's life over for all the hurt it would cause me to do it. But then I realized that's not a true statement, that I could get through anything. Years ago, about five to seven years ago, I think now, was my ex-wife and I went through a miscarriage. I thought the hurt of a miscarriage would always be there, never be anything worse than that. Then you go through, you know, anything else in life that's worse than that, and you realize that there's more to life that can hurt you.
Yes.
But how you deal with it is the whole process.
Yes.
And so God is taking me right now. He's saying to me, okay, when you're away and the Word of God is being preached, or if you're listening to something like what you're listening to right now, I'm speaking to you, Brian. And I'm telling you, listen to what my word says. So when you guys are talking tonight, I'm listening. I'm going, Lord, this is the second night in a row. You know, you're speaking to me. You're doing things.
Yes.
And I just want to say this, and I'm going to hush. I came home last night, and over here in Evans, I was at my mom's house, and I came home, and I sat in here, and the Lord said, you get up, you go lay hands on your mother, and you pray for her. And I did. And, man, the Holy Ghost power hit this house last night.
Praise
and I'm
God.
Telling you, God's moving.
All right.
So you guys keep me in your prayers. And I'm telling you now, I love you guys. Pastor Washington, you know, you're dear to my heart and your family. And Sister Andy
yes.
Washington, you guys are awesome. And we love you doing an awesome job at the radio station there and at your church. And God bless you for all that you're doing tonight.
Thank you so
all
much,
right.
brother. I appreciate
yes.
you. And we love you back.
That's right.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much.
All right, sir. We'll talk to you soon.
All right.
All right. God bless you.
Bye-bye.
Amen. Thank God for that caller, Pastor
yes.
Brian Finley. A lot of things that he was talking about, Pastor Grimes, it resonated with me, as
yeah.
well as sometimes we can be so busy
yes.
as leaders
mm-hmm.
leading, but yet not feeding
That's
ourselves.
Right. That's exactly right.
And speak to that.
Well, one of the things that Pastor Finley said is that he was hurting. But we want to believe that we may have moved past it or we have gotten over it. Mm-hmm. Intellectually, we can acknowledge it. We can acknowledge, okay, yes, I've been hurt. Intellectually, I can say that I've forgiven the individual. Mm-hmm. But the seeds of everything that was around that is still working on the inside of me.
Yes.
And unless I deal with it, it actually starts eating me or eroding from the inside out.
Yes.
So, one, it'll eventually affect my time in the Word. It'll affect my prayer. So a lot of things wind up getting touched by that. That's mm-hmm. why I said, you just got to be honest with you.
You know, as you were speaking, I'm going to jump in here real quick. As you were speaking, I thought about physically a body. When a person is ill, mm-hmm. or when a person is sick, if they don't continue to eat or feed their body or nourish their body, the body starts eating on itself.
Yes.
The gastro acids mm-hmm. In the body begins to eat away the lining of the stomach, etc. And I thought about the spiritual connotation to that. What would be whenever we don't have a continuous feeding of the Word, then the flesh spiritually so begins to eat itself.
Yeah.
Begins to eat away at us.
Mm-hmm.
The problem begins to eat at us. And it causes us to get in a place where it basically kills us.
Mm-hmm.
I want to come back to that, but I want to go to the Kingdom Talk phone lines real quick. Caller, you are live on the air with Kingdom Talk. Tell me where you're calling from, and if you have a question or comment, you can go forward.
God bless you. I am calling from the North Augusta, South Carolina area.
Praise God.
And I just wanted to add an addendum to your commentary, along with the Pastor Grimes, when you're talking about whenever you don't release and, you know, the unforgiveness and all of that and how it works inwardly. And the scripture that came to me was in Psalm 32 when David himself had sinned and had plotted to have Uriah killed, and how he said as long as he kept that sin within, it was eating away at him. But once he confessed it, he was delivered.
Yeah.
Wow.
And I just wanted to add that because a lot of times we hold things and we think our sins are being covered up. But I think Pastor Grimes was bringing out a point that how it eats away at us. And, you know, it literally deteriorates us naturally, and it's definitely deteriorating us spiritually because it causes us not to be able to really press into the things that we really need to spiritually in order to have that spiritual nourishment. So I just wanted to add that. And again, it was coming from Psalm 32nd chapter. So I am being encouraged by the broadcast, and I pray God continue to strengthen you all to do his work. Amen.
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 Thank you so much. We appreciate you.
You're welcome.
Amen. You know, I'm listening at the commentary of those that are calling in, and just where God has taken the conversation piece here tonight. And Pastor Graham, I'm convinced of this one thing, that where we are prophetically and where we're going, there's going to have to be a great level of, number one, forgiveness and dealing with ourselves so that we can be in a position to deal with what's coming.
Exactly.
I'm just convinced of that, because it's so, I'm telling you, as we sit here tonight, we were in Bible study on last night, and we were actually dealing with, for the last probably 2 months, we've been in just going through the books of Romans. But last night, God says, I want you to go away from that, and I want you to deal with this unforgiveness. And I'm telling you, it was, I don't know how, it was just a blessing, just holistically. It was a blessing spiritually. It was a blessing emotionally with many people.
Yeah.
And because one of the things I'm convinced of is that the reason why God can't do a lot of the things that he wants to do, it's not just some of the other things that we've touched on in times past, but this unforgiveness, yeah. People saying that they're forgiving, and this anger, mm-hmm. this, you know, we say intellectually, mm-hmm. I'm done with it and yeah. I'm over it. But emotionally and spiritually, what we've done is we pushed it under the proverbial rug. Mm-hmm. And what has happened is we keep doing that. That lump gets higher and higher.
That's
and
right.
We soon trip up over the thing that we say we're done with, are we forgiven? And I'm telling you, this thing, God is going to bring some healing behind a lot of this stuff.
It has to happen, because what we don't recognize is when you go through an experience,
yes,
a hurt, a betrayal mm-hmm. of something of that nature, there's another dynamic that we haven't talked about okay. that we have to be aware of.
Yes.
And that is the spirit of pride.
Oh.
Because we can mask the hurt that's really there because we want to appear or feel like we have to appear, especially if you're a leader.
Yes.
That you have to appear as if, okay, the rock was thrown. It hit the armor, but it didn't penetrate.
Yes.
But on the inside, because one, the enemy will always offer you. Mm-hmm. He'll bring it back. He'll rehearse it.
Yes.
Yeah. You'll hear it. So you can't ignore it.
Yes.
But you have to go ahead and acknowledge that.
Acknowledge.
This is where it is.
Yeah.
And then for a long time, you may be able to deny it, thinking that I moved past it. It's not really eating at me.
Mm-hmm.
But then start monitoring your prayer time.
Mm-hmm.
Here's another key. Monitor, am I hearing God
mm-hmm.
on the level that I was before?
Yes.
Or has that begun to deteriorate some?
Yes.
I mean, even to the point where you says, hey, what's going on? Lord, I'm not hearing you.
Yes.
Like I once did.
Yeah.
See, these God in his loving way are giving us some flags.
Absolutely.
He's putting out some caution signs for us to begin to look at.
Yes.
So that we can go ahead and acknowledge that and then begin to deal with it.
You know, one of the things that Pastor Brian was saying, Brian Finley, was saying that the Lord basically, and I'm not quoting him verbatim, but this is what I surmised from his commentary, was the Lord made him deal with that issue.
Yeah.
Brought it back to
yeah.
him. And I think what has to happen, and you know, one of the reasons I'm convinced, Pastor Grime and all my Kingdom Talk listeners, that when people start missing coming to the sanctuary,
mm-hmm.
it's because they don't want their vitals checked.
Yes. Yeah.
When you're in the hospital, every so often, they check your vitals.
Yes.
Because they want to monitor you to see if you're either getting well or worse.
Right.
So I stopped coming because I don't want anybody to see my vital signs go down because
yeah.
I'm really wounded.
Yes.
And I'm hurt and I'm
right.
scarred. So I'm going to back away from this thing so no one will check my vital signs.
And with that being said, Pastor, that's one of the most important things for us in the body of Christ to begin to recognize.
Yes. I feel Jesus.
We are supposed to be healing agents. And,
yes.
And something we had talked about earlier about the division.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what's happening many times in our churches, where we have congregated.
Mm. Yes.
As a people. But are we really united
yes.
as a people?
Absolutely.
Because see, this is supposed to be a spirit to spirit knitting.
Yes.
And when that begins to take place, that's where the strength in the body of Christ begins to come from.
Yes.
Because while I'm hurting, I'm drawing strength from my brothers and sisters in Christ.
Yes, sir.
But we have to recognize that this is so necessary. But we have to be honest to get rid of all the junk that we walking around with. The pride, the envy, the unforgiveness, all of those things that's happening in the body, in the church.
Yes.
And then we wonder why we can't have a move of God.
I want to go to social media, Pastor Grimes. Jacqueline Surrey, And I want to welcome also Jacynthia Walton. She's tuned in and listening. I want to say a great big God bless you to you as well. And we have actually looked like maybe two questions. Jacqueline says, how do you deal with unforgiveness that you don't know you have? And then Jacynthia says, I'm just tuning in. Unforgiveness will keep us in bondage. It's like walking around with a straight jacket. That was her commentary on that. That was pretty interesting as well. Sister Jacqueline says, how do you deal with unforgiveness that you don't know you have? That's a very interesting question. That's loaded too, I think. I'm going to let you deal with it first. Since you're my guest, I'm going to put you on the hot seat.
Unforgiveness that you don't know that you have.
I have a quick answer for that, but I'm going to let you.
Well, first of all, if you can recognize that there was something that occurred, some incident, something that has occurred in which you felt either offended, then you already know that the door was already open there.
Okay.
So now that once that happened and you say, okay, the door is open, how do I close that door?
Mm-hmm.
And again, one, go ahead and acknowledge the fact that, okay, yeah, this thing did offend me.
Yes.
Now, we have some struggles here because we don't always want to do what the word says do in Matthew 18, where it tells us, you know, if my brother offend me, I go to him by myself and present, you know, the thing. And here's the thing. When you present it, don't go present anything in an attack mode of the person. Always present the issue. And this is what it made me feel like when you did that. Maybe they will receive it, maybe they won't. But then once you've done that and you've done, now I, you know, God, I've done what you've asked me to do, at least to go to them.
Mm-hmm.
They didn't receive me. So I want to walk free from this. So I'm giving this to you. And every time the enemy would seek to bring that back, because if it's coming back to you, it's not God. Know that.
Right.
When you think about it tomorrow morning, it's not God. That's the enemy. So now, if you have sought to forgive him, then you continue and continue to put it before God. So when I say, when you said unforgiveness that you don't know that you have, just know that if there has been an offense, then the doorway was already open for that. So now you can begin dealing with it from that standpoint.
Amen. Great commentary and great answer to that question. And then I would say you can't deal with something that you don't know. But if you're saying, how do you deal with it if you don't know you have it, then 9 times out of 10, you probably know that there's something there. But you may be trying to rationalize whether, you know, I want to deal with it or not. One of the things that we were talking about is a lot of times people just don't like confrontation and they don't want to deal with that scripture as what you were talking about, going to the person. But very good questions and commentaries here on Kingdom Talk. We welcome your question and your comments as well. So you can chime in. We got a few more minutes, and you can call in as well. Your numbers of access are 803-335-3131. You're inside the live broadcast of Kingdom Talk. I am your host, Augustus Washington Jr., and our special guest tonight is Pastor Reginald Grimes, and we are just dealing with some various things, unforgiveness being one of the conversational pieces that we're dealing with tonight, as well as spirit, soul, and body. How we as believers, the body of Messiah Jesus, how do we function in these things as it relates to those components? Because again, we are, number one, spirit. We live in a body, which gives us allows us to be cognizant of our social order. And we have a soul, or the solical realm, where we reason, you know, all of those various things. So So this is what we've been dealing with tonight. But it appears that the unforgiveness piece is somewhat dominated just a little.
The second, was it Jacqueline?
Jacynthia.
Jacynthia.
Mm-hmm.
What was her comment again?
Her comment was, unforgiveness will keep us in bondage. It's like walking around with a straitjacket.
That is so true. Because once you've been, you feel like you've been violated, you feel like you've been hurt. Again, you have to process all of the thoughts that come to your mind.
Yes.
And what's important, even when we recognize this, if we get this, and the piece that we say that every thought that comes is not your thought. And if it's something that keeps rehearsing the hurt or rehearsing the pain, that's not really the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
So the enemy is trying to do that because he wants to keep you in that place.
Yes.
So that's where, when it comes, then that's when we have to do what the word tells us in 2 Corinthians chapter 10. We have to cast down some of these thoughts, these images.
Yes.
I choose not to harbor this. And even though you speak the words, but you may not sense anything, just recognize that your words are spirit.
Mm-hmm.
So you got to put them in the atmosphere so that from the spiritual realm, this can begin to start working, because you have to basically dominate your soulish realm by living from your spirit. And
yes.
The only way we're going to do that is by the word of God.
Amen.
So as you continue to do that, then we can break some of the chains off of the straitjackets that keep us bound.
Yes. Amen. Listen, we're just about out of time. I want to get ready to exit the broadcast because I want us to pray. And I want to pray specifically for unforgiveness and for healing. I want to pray for unforgiveness and healing tonight. I just sense that in the spirit tonight. I want to pray for unforgiveness and healing tonight before we end the broadcast. I want to give you 30 seconds. I want you to give me your final and closing remarks. But let me go back to the Kingdom Talk phone lines and see what this caller. Caller, you're live on the air with Kingdom Talk. What's your question or comment?
Hey, how are you?
I'm absolutely wonderful. How are you?
That's great. I'm blessed. My question is, how do I know if I'm religious?
How do you know if you are religious? Is that the question?
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right. Pastor Grimes, you want to chime in on that first? Or
let me first ask you this, sister. Do you know that you have received Christ as your personal Lord and Savior?
Yes, sir.
You're sure of that?
Yes.
Okay. Then, now that you've been born again, the process of growing is to learn how to live according to God's way by His Word. A good place is Romans chapter 8, where it speaks about beginning to live by the Spirit of God that's on the inside of you.
Mm-hmm.
Not just going through the motions and the acts of things that you've been taught or seen or observed as far as church is concerned. So being religious, in a sense, is doing works.
Mm-hmm.
Because those are the things that have a label as these are the good things that you're supposed to do by being in church. But being born again is about relationship.
Yes.
And it's living from your relationship with the God that saved you. So the more that you seek Him through His word and seek to understand and to know His voice, then you'll begin walking with Him, because the Spirit of God is on the inside of you now.
He was the one that caused the new birth to take place inside of you. Your spirit is now reborn. So he's in there. Just begin to invite him into your day. Ask him to teach you to, you know, teach you to know his voice. And even as you begin reading and in scripture and you'll begin praying, you'll begin sensing and hearing his inner voice.
Yes.
And then from that, that inner voice will begin to lead and guide and direct you. But he will never lead, guide, and direct you contrary to what the Word of God says.
Amen. Does that help you out?
It does. Thank you so much.
You're very welcome, and thank you for listening, tuning in. God bless you. Amen. You know, that's a very valid and good question as well.
Yeah.
Because a lot of people are, we hear that phraseology a lot, but mm-hmm. sometimes people don't really know what you mean when you say that.
Yeah.
But I think number one, for her to have asked the question is a super start.
Exactly.
Because that means you really want to know.
Right.
And you want to get it right. And you want to make sure that you're right.
Yeah.
And I want to just echo what you were saying. I know we got to get out of here, but I want to echo what you were saying earlier, because it's a relationship. And religion gives you rules and practices.
Mm, yes.
Relationship gives you access.
Yes.
I'm going to say that again. Religion gives you rules and practices, rituals.
Mm-hmm.
Relationship gives you access.
Yes.
When I have relationship with you, let me say it this way. If I go to your home right now, I can't do in your home what your wife does in your home. Different relationship.
Right.
So it gives me a certain amount of access, but then someone that does not know you at all can't even get in the home.
Exactly.
Because relationship gives me access.
Right.
So when we are in a relationship with God, we give him access to us as well as we have access to him. And then he then tells us the particulars of how to do. It's not just going to the house of worship on Sunday, but it's the position of the heart when you go.
Yes.
It's not just, because see, some people think just because a person speaks in tongues that they're saved. That's not true.
That's exactly right.
Because a parrot can speak in tongues if you listen at you long enough.
Yes.
Maybe we'll do a broadcast on this together real soon, because we're out of time. I want you to give me 20 seconds and pray for those that are dealing with unforgiveness and speak healing over the people tonight.
Father, we come to you in the name of Jesus. And Lord, for all of our listeners out there who may be carrying or dealing with some type of hurt, some type of pain,
yes.
some type of betrayal, we lift them up right now. We plead the blood of Jesus over their minds.
Yes, God.
And we pray right now, Lord, that even as they acknowledge that before you, that they would give it to you.
Yes.
That they would know, Lord, how much you love them. And Father, that they would trust you where they can't love, to love through them.
Yes, God.
Until they're able to love.
Yes.
Father, I pray right now for the healing of their emotions, the healing of their minds. I pray right now, Lord, that there will be life from their spirit that will overflow, Lord, to the soulless realm, Heavenly Father. And that through your word, Lord, that you will begin to draw them and strengthen them. And that they would know, Lord God, that you love them unconditionally. And Father, we just thank you right now in advance.
Yes, God.
For those who you're ministering to right now. And Lord, that you will continue to send those across their path that will give them words of encouragement, Heavenly
yes,
Father, that they will sense and begin to hear your voice, Lord, in the secret place, Lord. And then from your voice, Lord, that they will be drawn to your presence in Jesus' name.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen. Listen, we're out of time. We got to get out of here, but we appreciate you. We love you to life. We thank God for you. And we pray that you will continue to go forward in your journey in the Lord. And I want you to have an awesome night on tonight. If the Lord tarries, we'll be back next week, same time, same station. And I want you to be blessed, all right? God bless you. Have a wonderful night.
You've been listening to Kingdom Talk. The views and opinions of this broadcast may or may not be the views and opinions of this radio station, staff, and or ownership. We thank you for listening to Kingdom Talk, and we appreciate all of your calls. Remember to tune in to Kingdom Talk every Thursday from 7 until 8 p.m. And remember that you are a king's kid, so always speak up, speak life, speak kingdom, Kingdom Talk. Until next Thursday, God bless you and good night.
God bless you. You're listening to 99.9.